Today, we look at some sandwiches from a local retailer called Percy, Ingles.
It's time for Small Store Sandwiches. Welcome to the start of a new series that we're going to do on small local retailers of our favourite thing, sandwiches.
You've got your big superstores that we will always look at, your Tesco's, your Marks & Spencer, your Greggs. But let's look at the locals. Let's keep them thriving and going. And by doing that, they come out with some gems like this.
We'll see if they're gems.
I have got a chicken and bacon and lettuce and, you know, your usual chicken and bacon sandwich. It looks sesame seed roll, yeah?
Sesame seed roll, yeah.
And Percy Ingle are mainly known for their bread, right?
Bread.
So the bread has to be good without that.
It feels quite pleasant.
Yeah, it feels nice, crunchy.
Yeah.
And how much were these? Do we know?
I think this is about £2.45.
Yeah, you know, it's around the sandwich region. It's not cheap. It's not expensive.
About two and a half a piece.
Yeah, and well, we got them for free.
We didn't pay for them.
Mike got a girlfriend in the sandwich industry.
Basically,
clever move.
I saw her and I thought, this girl, she knows her way around the sandwich. So listen, I was sold.
We all like sandwiches, but I don't know if I'd get into a relationship just because of sandwiches.
See, that's why I'm serious about sandwiches.
Yeah, that's very true, very true.
Should we
begin to our first serving? Should we start with the chicken and bacon or that? What is that again? I'm not listening.
Sorry, seafood cocktail here and chicken and bacon Caesar here with crispy bacon. Same thing.
Okay. All right. Let's try the chicken and bacon Caesar. We're cutting on a chopping board for the first time.
I've got a question. What does Caesar mean?
Oh, so you know the ruler, Sir Caesar Palace.
Oh, Caesar, Julius Caesar.
Yeah, he created a sauce mainly known for his sandwiches.
Really?
Yeah, mainly known for his salads, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
You've blown my mind.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Oh, hang on.
It looks lovely and full. I mean, we showed you the beginning clips, but
it smells bacony.
You couldn't see that much inside, and that looks delicious.
That's a good portion of chicken. Not much bacon, though, I have to say. But you wouldn't want much bacon.
Well, it's crispy bacon, so you don't need much.
Oh, well, if it's crispy, it's
salty. First off, though, the sandwich isn't big. It was one big major
that is
worry.
Literally
right
just
off
a
the bat.
Slight snack.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm gonna say it now. This is not your lunchtime thing. She has two of them for lunch.
I'd need three of them.
I'd probably personally
multi bag.
Three and a family pack of crisps. Mm. This isn't enough food for lunch, but let's put it there.
Let's go. On.
Cheers.
That's lovely. That is absolutely delicious.
Not bad at all.
The chicken tastes so fresh.
I was expecting it to be salty with the chicken, with the bacon.
Well, I don't know if I've got a big bacon bite there. But, oh, I mean, I could carry on this all day. It's really nice.
That's very nice.
It's actually one of the freshest sandwiches I've ever had. And listen, I eat the Greggs equivalent of that quite often. Their chicken club baguette. Bacon, chicken and lettuce.
These are past the sell-by dates.
But this is much... this is much nicer. Don't get me wrong. This is much nicer than the Greggs. It is too small, but it is brilliant.
Way too small. But think about it. If you did have to pay for them, you'd have to buy three, which is like £7.
It's too much. So on a taste rating, out of 10, I'm going to go right up there and give it a 9.
8.
A 9 and an 8. And presentation? It actually doesn't look that great.
It looks like shit. I'd probably give it a 6, to be honest. And that's just being nice.
5 from me for that. And finally, value.
It's about 0.6.
But we have talked about the size of it.
Oh, no, actually, sorry. So 5.
It's going to have to be a 5 from me as well. But taste is right up there with one of the nicest sandwiches I've consumed on this channel. You know, I mean, I can't speak for previous occasions.
Okay.
Yeah, get that seafood cut open. Big thumbs up for the chicken Caesar there. Percy Ingles, was it 52 stores around England?
52 or 54, she said, yeah.
Compare that to Greg's, which has 1,500 stores.
And there's a couple of them that open all night, work for the drunks. This is genuinely, Birmingham.
Nah,
check it,
bullshit.
It genuinely happens. I know this kind of thing because I'm serious about
sandwiches. Don't believe it. What is this then? Seafood cocktail? What
right,
seafood
this is
do we
seafood
see?
Cocktail, but what she told me right at the start is that it has crab in it, and that's kind of told me. It's all I've actually eaten from
crab. So there's obviously prawn in there, surely?
To be honest with you, I don't know. I was eating it the other day and I saw, like, you know, fish sticks with the bright red things in
them.
Oh,
dear Lord.
But genuinely, it's pretty decent. I was quite happy with it.
Let's go for it. Seafood cocktail.
Seafood cocktail. Fishy as fuck.
Very fishy. Tastes like a prawn cocktail.
Yeah, but the thing is, I got a seafood cocktail, you know the sandwich mixes they do in Tesco's? I got that one time at work because I was feeling greedy and I had like a whole baguette of it.
I've been there.
And it wasn't as nice as that, to be honest.
It is nice, and do you know one thing all round? The lettuce is really fresh and really, really nice. And that's a big fault in, you know, the biggest sandwiches that are sold because they're not as fresh as this.
You don't get the crunch.
And that lettuce is outstanding. So, yeah, I mean, I'm going to have one more bite and then give it my final rating.
Yeah.
It's still delicious.
You know what?
What?
I'm going to tell you, I normally avoid seafood when I'm hungover because it doesn't settle your stomach, but that still does.
Oh, I wouldn't go near
it. It doesn't anger my stomach.
Alright. Taste, out of 10?
Probably a 7.
Yeah, it's a solid 7 for me. Value?
Still, to be honest, a 5. That's about...
It's got to go down.
I think that's
really
coming up on £3. I think that's 4. At the most.
It's going to get a 4.
I think even less.
Value for
be.
Me. Presentation, it again, doesn't... Looks I mean, like the roll looks nice,
the
but
roll.
The problem is you can see very little ingredients and that
nice.
Will sway people away without
well, that's
doubt.
What they do best in Greg's, basically at the end
yeah.
of the sandwich.
Shows you all the ingredients.
They put all
yeah.
the ingredients right at the front, but
it's cheeky.
They don't lie to you in
it's
that.
Cheeky, but it works, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's it. A really, really good, positive review of Percy Ingle. And we'll be starting to look more and more at independent stores. You know, the local ones. If you've got any in mind, let us know and we'll pop down there. Any around London especially.
This is the start of a new series. This is episode 1, and we're going to go on local, independent, little bakeries. And that's where we're going from here.
I'm going on from that. Any ideas you've got for us, anything you want us to review, whack it down
please
in the comments.
Let us know.
We will listen to you.
We will do it.
We read all our comments. I mean, we get loads.
We get a lot, yeah.
We read them, don't you worry.
We do.
And shout out to the guy who saw us in Dublin the other day.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
Like, comment and subscribe if you enjoyed it. And we will see you in the next video.
Been a pleasure.